so fine. I'd weave a magic strand of rainbow design, of rainbow design. Far over the waters, I'd reach my magic band. So they'd understand.
Kind of an old-fashioned banjo I'm playing. Made by hand, all out of wood, except for a piece of stovepipe in the center. The man who made it was a great banjo picker, a fine man, Frank Proffitt of North Carolina. And since I'm playing his old-fashioned kind of banjo, I'll sing an old-fashioned kind of song. This actually was one of Abe Lincoln's favorite songs, I hear tell. One of his friends, one of Lincoln's friends, was a banjo player, Ward Hill Lehman. I think he was a lawyer around Springfield back in the early days. And he used to play this song for Lincoln. Long time ago, long time ago, with a little black bull come down the meadow. Long time ago, little black bull come down the meadow. Who's in Johnny? Who's in Johnny? The little black bull come down the meadow. Long time ago, long time ago, long time ago, the little black bull come down the meadow. Long time ago. First he paw and then he beller. Who's in Johnny? Who's in Johnny? First he paw, then he beller. Long time ago, long time ago, long time ago, with a little black bull come down the meadow. Long time ago. He pawed the dirt in the heifers' faces. Who's in Johnny? Who's in Johnny? Pawed the dirt in the heifers' faces. Long time ago. Long time ago. Long time ago. With a little black bull come down the meadow. Long time ago. His eye at the little red heifer. Who's in Johnny? Who's in Johnny? Wink his eye at the little red heifer. Long time ago, long time ago, long time ago, with a little black bull come down the meadow. Long time ago. Little black bull come down the meadow. Who's in Johnny? Who's in Johnny? The little black bull come down the meadow. Long time ago. Long time ago. Oh, long time ago. With the little black bull coming down the meadow. Long time ago. The tune, probably you've heard that chorus before. The old gray mare. And that tune came from an earlier old gospel song. It was used for one of Abe Lincoln's campaign songs when he first came out of the state of Illinois to run for president. Down in Illinois, down in Illinois, old Abe Lincoln come out of the wilderness down in Illinois. They compared him to Jesus coming out of the wilderness after 40 days to speak to the people. Old Abe Lincoln come out of the wilderness, out of the wilderness, out of the wilderness. Old Abe Lincoln come out of the wilderness, down in Illinois. Down in Illinois, down in Illinois. Old Abe Lincoln came out of the wilderness, down in Illinois. A long man, and he stands tall in the minds of all kinds of people. Of course, it's easy to forget how he was argued about in those days. He didn't even get to the White House on a majority of votes, you know. I think something like 40 or 45% of the people voted for him, but the others were split between the Northern Democrats and the Southern Democrats. A lot of things he stood for were hated by a lot of people. And we take it for granted now. Take a song like this, came out of those days. Kids know it in school, it's hung around, but in those days, this was a controversial song. John Brown's body lies a-moldering in the grave. John Brown's body lies a-moldering in the grave. John Brown's body lies a-moldering in the grave, but his soul goes marching on. He captured Harper's Ferry with his 19 men so true. He frightened old Virginia till she trembled through and through. They hung him for a traitor, they themselves the traitor crew, but his soul goes marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His soul goes marching on. The stars above in heaven are looking kindly down. The stars above in heaven are looking kindly down. The stars above in heaven are looking kindly down on the grave of old John Brown. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His soul goes marching on. Because John Brown was one of those abolitionists, too. And it was his scheme. People said he was crazy, but it was actually a very well thought out scheme. He was going to found an independent state of escaped slaves somewhere in the Appalachian Mountains, a kind of a guerrilla stronghold. And then other slaves would flee to it. Before long, they'd have thousands and tens of thousands. Not all the abolitionists agreed with him. Frederick Douglass had his last meeting with John Brown and went out with tears in his eyes, but went back to his home. He wouldn't go along with him. John Brown's body lies a-moldering in the grave. John Brown's body lies a-moldering in the grave. John Brown's body lies a-moldering in the grave, but his soul goes marching on. Of course, Lincoln was all caught up in this big argument about the abolition, abolitionists. When the Republican Party was founded in his own hometown of Springfield, there were a lot of abolitionists in the group, and he felt, well, he'd better be leery of being too closely associated with them at first. And on the Sunday that they met, he didn't want to actually say no to them, but he didn't feel he should say yes. He went for a long ride in the country in a buggy. Didn't say no or yes. And pretty soon, the temper of the country showed that this new Republican Party was going to be the thing, and he became their leading candidate, of course. There was another group of abolitionists called the Hutchinson family. I think I'll sing you a couple of their songs, or at least one of them. They're a little bit like the almanac singers of their day. They made up songs about what was going on, sang some old ones and some new ones. Lowell, Massachusetts, Hutchinson family, half a dozen or more. They hope to meet 400 men and 800 women. With ears of sympathy, minds of sympathy, and eyes open to hear songs against slavery, songs to elevate women to their equal right. Old bachelors accompanied with a sympathizing associate of the gentle sex, free, gratis, for nothing. Fugitive slaves, not only free, but everyone who will prove himself more shall be presented with a dollar and a quarter. No discount for counterfeit money. The Hutchins family were one of the leading vocal groups of the 1840s and 50s. But as I say, they were highly controversial. When the Civil War broke out, they went down to sing for the Union troops. And the general, he was against the abolitionists. He thought they were terrible people. He said, there's the ones causing all the trouble, and he wouldn't let them sing. So Abe Lincoln asked if he could see the words of the songs they planned to sing. And after looking them over, he said, well, if there's something wrong with these songs, we're fighting the wrong war. And concert went ahead. There was a girl and her three brothers in the group, Abby Hutchinson and the three brothers. You can see that was quite the fashionable thing. They're not beatniks as they would be nowadays, but just fashionable beards of 1840s and 50s. And one of their songs was, I can't remember them all. There's one called The Bereaved Slave Mother, with a picture of a slave auction going on there. Then there was another one they had called Get Off the Track. They put new words to that popular song of the day and sang it like this. Get off the track, emancipation, roll it along through the nation, roll it along through the nation, freedom's car, emancipation. Emancipation rides majestic through our nation, bearing on its wheels the story, liberty, your nation's glory. Roll it along through the nation, roll it along through the nation, roll it along through the nation, freedom's car, emancipation. Men of various predilections, frightened, run in all directions, lawyers, editors, physicians, merchants, priests, and politicians. Roll it along through the nation, roll it along through the nation, roll it along through the nation, freedom's car, emancipation. Roll it along through the nation, freedom's car, emancipation. Roll it along through the nation, freedom's car, emancipation. Stick around, we'll have some more controversial songs, even though they're 100 years old, maybe. I'll be back in just a minute. What makes a controversial song depends entirely upon your opinion, of course. In those days, many a song would be controversial, which nowadays nobody bothers arguing about. They just write it up and put it in the history textbooks, and it's all over with. But they had songs about the Boston Tea Party, for example. Ballads telling how they dumped the tea in the harbor. And these songs could be argued about, and if you were on the wrong side, you'd get in a fight. Songs about the battles of the day, every war that was ever fought. And again, if you were on the wrong side, then you had to pay for it. Nowadays, we don't bother thinking about it. If we remember the song at all, it's just something quaint in the history books. Oh, sometimes they're funny. You know, the battles they used to have in those arguments they used to have 100 years ago about the temperance movement. And the prohibitionists would sing, cold water for me. There's nothing so pure and so free. I'll go to the brook and I'll go to the spring. And over the bubbles I'll merrily sing. Cold water, cold water for me. There's nothing like water to give the strength that we need for to live. I'll go through the woods, I'll go to the spring, and over the bubbles I'll merrily sing. Cold water, cold water for me. Oh, I'm afraid the drinkers had all the best songs, though. Or at least most of them. Rye, whiskey, it's whiskey I cry. If you don't give me rye whiskey, surely we'll die. Way up on Clinch Mountain, I wander alone. I'm drunk as the devil, just let me alone. Rye, whiskey, whiskey, I cry. If you don't give me rye whiskey, I surely will. Oh, you know, that's a fake. I'm stone cold sober. I can't sing that song right now. And besides, as I say, it doesn't seem controversial anymore. At least not so much. Ooh, let's see, though. In the 1880s, they had all kinds of songs made up when the farmers started getting organized. Grange movement, the Greenback Party, the populists. When the farmer comes to town with his wagon broken down, oh, the farmer is the man that feeds them all. If you'll only look and see, I think you will agree that the farmer is the man that feeds them all. Oh, the farmer is the man, the farmer is the man, lives on credit till the fall. With the interest rate so high, it's a wonder he don't die, and the middleman's the one that gets it all. Oh, the banker says he's broke, and the merchant's up in smoke, but the farmer is the man that feeds them all. It would put them to the test if the farmer took a rest, then they'd know that it's the farmer feeds them all. Oh, the farmer is the man, the farmer is the man, lives on credit till the fall. And his pants are wearing thin, his condition it's a sin, he's forgot that he's the man that feeds them all. Well, as I said, they had songs about the farmers, had songs about the eight-hour-day movement, all the old-time labor troubles they had. Around the year of 1910, it was, there was a longshoreman working on the docks in San Pedro, California. And they went out on strike for higher wages, and the railroad engineers that worked for the same railroad company refused to join the strike. They said, we got our union, we're making good wages, we're not going to bother helping you. So this longshoreman wrote a satire on the railroad engineers. He put his words to a popular tune of the day, a tune we think is an old folk song. It was a pop song in 1910, Casey Jones. And this longshoreman, his name was Joe Hill, a young fellow of Swedish background. His words swept the country. Oh, the workers on the SP line for strike set out a call. But Casey Jones, the engineer, he wouldn't strike at all. His boilerette was leaking and the drivers on the bum. And the engines and the baron, they were all out of plumb. Casey Jones kept his junk pile running. Casey Jones was doing double time. Casey Jones got a wooden medal for being good and faithful on the SP line. Well, the worker said to Casey, won't you help us win this strike? But Casey said, let me alone, you'd better take a hike. Well, Casey's wheezy engine ran right off the wheezy track, and Casey hit the river with an awful smack. Casey Jones hit the river bottom. Casey Jones broke his bloomin' spine. Casey Jones became an Angelino. He took a trip to heaven on the SP line. Casey got to heaven way up to that pearly gate. He said, I'm Casey Jones, the guy that pulled the SP freight. You're just the man, said Peter, our musicians are on strike. You can get a job of scabbing anytime you like. Casey Jones got a job in heaven. Casey Jones was doing mighty fine. Casey Jones went scabbing on the angels, just like he did to workers on the SP line. Well, the angels got together and they said it wasn't fair for Casey Jones to go around a scabbing everywhere. The angel union number 23, they sure were there, and they promptly fired Casey down the golden stair. Casey Jones, I went to hell a-flying. Casey Jones, the devil said, oh, fine. Casey Jones, get busy shoveling sulfur. It's what you get for scabbing on the Salt Lake line. Well, we have a few more songs coming up present times pretty soon. Hang around, I'll be back. Ooh, it's getting hot in here. The fellow that made up that song about Casey Jones, that is, these different words, this Joe Hill, made up a whole batch of songs. And even though he's been dead now many years, he was framed and executed in Utah and just about 50 years ago. Songs are still going all around. They used to have a little songbook. When I say they, we called them the Wobblies, because their initials are IWW, IWW, the Wobblies. Some people said it stood for I Won't Work, but they said it's the International Workers of the World. And in the little songbook, well, this one is still sung. They go wild, simply wild over me, but I've never done them harm that I could see. Yet on me they put a ban, they threw me in the can. They go wild, simply wild over me. Oh, the bull, he went wild over me. He held his club where everyone could see. He was breathing mighty hard when he saw my union card. He went wild, simply wild over me. And the judge, he went wild over me. I plainly saw we never could agree. So I let his nibs obey what his conscience had to say. He went wild, simply wild over me. And the jailer, he went wild over me. He locked me up and threw away the key. Yes, it seems to be the rage. They like to keep me in a cage. They go wild, simply wild over me. They grow wild, simply wild over me. I'm referring to the bedbug and the flea. They disturb my slumber deep. They rob me of my sleep. They go wild, simply wild over me. Will the roses grow wild over me when I'm gone into the land that is to be? When my soul and body part in the stillness of my heart, will the roses grow wild over me? Along came 1931, and there was a whole rash of songs written about what was going on. I was born long ago in 1894. I've seen many a panic, I will own. I've been hungry, I've been cold, and now I'm growing old. But the worst I've seen is 1931. Oh, those beans, bacon, and gravy, they almost drive me crazy. I eat them till I see them in my dreams, when I wake up in the morning and another day is dawning, I know I'll get another mess of beans. Congregate each morning at the county barn at dawning. Everything is happy, so it seems. But when our day's work is done and we file in one by one, we know we'll get another mess of beans. Oh, those beans, bacon and gravy, they almost drive me crazy. I eat them till I see them in my dreams, when I wake up in the morning and another day is dawning, I know I'll get another mess of beans. Well, somebody will say, how come all these negative songs? I don't know exactly why. It's probably because when times are going good, people aren't writing the songs, perhaps. Maybe it's the same thing. Why are there so many unrequited love songs? About the boy getting jilted or the girl getting jilted or things going wrong. You rarely see a happy love song. I suppose when they're requited, they've got better things to do than sing songs. So it is that a lot of these songs are telling about troubles. 1932, there was a ballad made up in the coal fields of Kentucky. Let me get this tuned up right. Come and listen to my story. Come and listen to my song. I will tell you of a hero who's now dead and gone. I will tell you of a young boy, his age was 19. He was the bravest Union man that I have ever seen. Harry Sims was a pal of mine, we labored side by side, expecting to be shot on sight or taken for a ride by them dirty coal operator gun thugs who roam from town to town, a shooting down the Union men wherever they may be found. Harry Sims was walking down the track one bright sunshiny day. He was a youth of courage, his step was light and gay. He did not know the gun thugs was hiding on the way to kill our brave young comrade this bright sunshiny day. Harry Sims was killed on Brush Creek in 1932. He organized the miners into the NMU. He gave his life in struggle, that was all that he could do. He died for the Union, also for me and you. I got a few more songs. I don't know whether you'll call them controversial or not. Coming up to present times. Just a few minutes. Frank Proffitt, the man who made this banjo, sometimes used to sing a song that his grandfather had taught him, said it was a true story. Happened 100 years ago. I'm going across the mountains, oh, fare you well. Going across the mountains, you can hear my banjo tell. Got my rations on my back, my powder, it is dry. Going across the mountains, oh, Chrissy, don't you cry. I'm going across the mountains to join the boys in blue. When this fighting's over, I'll come back to you. Going across the mountains, if I have to crawl, to give old Jeff's men a little of my rifle ball. I expect you'll miss me when I'm gone, but I'm going through. When this fighting's over, I'll come back to you. Going across the mountains to join the boys in blue. When this fighting's over, I'll come back to you. Frank's grandfather lived down in North Carolina in the Smoky Mountains, just like you saw in the picture there. And you can bet your life that was a controversial song 100 years ago when he sang it. Here's a song, though, put together out of something I read in a newspaper about a year ago. King Henry marched forth, a sword in his hand. 2,000 horsemen all at his command. In a fortnight the rivers ran red through the land. The year 1520. The year it is now, 1965. It's easier far to stay half alive. Just keep your mouth shut while the planes zoom and dive. 10,000 miles over the ocean. Simon was drafted in 63. In 64, sent over the sea. Last month this letter he sent to me. He said you won't like what I'm saying. He said, we've no friends here, no hardly a one. We've got a few generals who just want our guns. But it'll take more than that if we're ever to win. Why, we'll have to flatten the country. It's my own troops I have to watch out for, he said. I sleep with a pistol right under my head. He wrote this last month, last week he was dead. And Simon came home in a casket. I mind my own business, I watch my TV. Complain about taxes, but pay anyway. In a civilized manner my forefathers betray, who long ago struggled for freedom. But each day a new headline screams at my bluff. On TV some general says we must be tough. In my dreams I stare at this family I love, all gutted and spattered with napalm. King Henry marched forth, a sword in his hand. 2,000 horsemen all at his command. In a fortnight the rivers ran red through the land. The year 1520. Here it is now, 1965. It's easier far to stay half alive. Just keep your mouth shut while the planes zoom and die. 10,000 miles over the ocean. Light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Every day, every day, gonna let my little light shine. I'm gonna let it shine. Jesus gave me a light. I'm gonna let it shine. Jesus gave me a light. I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. I've got the light of freedom. I'm gonna let it shine. Oh, I've got the light of freedom. I'm gonna let it shine. I've got the light of freedom. I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. I've got the light of freedom. I'm gonna let it shine. I've got the light of freedom. I'm gonna let it shine.
light of freedom. I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
When I get blue and pessimistic about this world, I sing some of the songs I learned from the good people down south, Alabama, Mississippi, Georgia. Kind of songs I heard in their churches. Old songs like the one I just sang, and the new verses they added to them. Just the last few years, there have been all kinds of these old songs that they brought forth again and put new verses to, sometimes completely new words. I was riding down the road in a car with some young people, and they suddenly bust loose with a song I'd never heard before. If you miss me at the back of the bus, you can't find me nowhere. Come on over to the front of the bus, I'll be riding up there. Yes, I'll be riding up there. I'll be riding up there. Oh, come on over to the front of the bus, I'll be riding up there. If you miss me on the picket line, you can't find me nowhere. Oh, come on over to the city jail, I'll be roaming over there. Yes, I'll be roaming over there. Yes, I'll be roaming over there. Come on over to the city jail, I'll be roaming over there. If you miss me in the cotton field, you can't find me nowhere. Oh, 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 come on over to the courthouse, I'll be voting right there. Yes, I'll be voting right there. Yes, I'll be voting right there. Oh, 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 come on over to the courthouse, I'll be voting right there. If you miss me in the Mississippi River, you can't find me nowhere. Oh, 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 come on over to the swimming pool, I'll be swimming right there. I'll be swimming right there. I'll be swimming right there. Oh, come on over to the swimming pool, I'll be swimming right there. Yes, if you miss me at the back of the bus, you can't find me nowhere. Oh, 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 come on over to the front of the bus, I'll be riding up there. Once more now, I'll be riding up there. I'll be riding up there. Oh, come on over to the front of the bus, I'll be riding up there. Young people, you know, they keep wanting to make up new verses, and each new event, whether it's in Birmingham last year, a couple of years ago, when they sicked the dogs on them, or some new time they get thrown in jail, well, you'll find some person making up some brand new verse right off the spot. And if you ask them, are you a songwriter? They says, oh, no, I don't write songs. I just made up some words. Ain't scared of your dogs, cause I want my freedom, I want my freedom, I want my freedom. Ain't scared of your dogs, cause I want my freedom, I want my freedom now. Ain't scared of your jail, cause I want my freedom, I want my freedom, I want my freedom. Ain't scared of your jail, I want my freedom, I want my freedom now. Ain't scared of your hoes, cause I want my freedom, I want my freedom, I want my freedom. Ain't scared of your hoes, I want my freedom, I want my freedom now. Yes, ain't scared of your dogs, cause I want my freedom, I want my freedom, I want my freedom. I'm scared of your dogs, cause I want my freedom, I want my freedom now. course, the greatest song of all, though, down there, is the old spiritual they made up new words for. Not completely new words. They changed just a few very important words. See, the old gospel song said, I will overcome. It was just a purely personal thing. I will overcome my problems. I will be like him. Then about 30 years ago, some tobacco workers down in South Carolina, it was, walking up and down, made up just a few changes, and they said, we will overcome. A friend of mine learned it, she taught it to me, and we added some new verses. A friend of mine took it down south in 1960 in the new version, and it spread all through the south. We shall overcome. We shall overcome. We shall overcome someday. Oh, deep in my heart, I do believe we shall overcome someday. We'll walk hand in hand. We'll walk hand in hand. Hand in hand someday. Oh, deep in my heart, I do believe we shall sung this song in 25 different countries of the world. I came to the conclusion it wasn't just a song for Alabama and Mississippi, but for any member of the human race, any place that gets a little discouraged and wonders what the future is going to bring. And this song has a kind of a calm confidence that says we can, we can. We shall overcome someday. Oh, 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 deep in my heart, I do believe we shall overcome someday. I believe it. Someday.
Oh, had I a goal.
and needles so fine. I'd weave a magic strand of rainbow design, of rainbow design. In it I'd weave the bravery of women giving birth. In it I'd weave the innocence of children over all the earth. Children of all earth, far over the water, I'd reach my magic band to every city, through every single land, through every land. Show my brothers and my sisters my rainbow design. Bind up this old world with hand and heart and mind. Hand and heart and mind. Oh, had I a golden thread and needles so fine, a magic strand of rainbow design. Oh.